Good evening. The entire east coast of Australia is under immediate threat from blackouts due to dangerously low reserves of electricity. Queenslanders are tonight being asked to conserve power by turning off their appliances, and New South Wales is next.
The east coast power system is running on empty.
There's literally no spare capacity in the Queensland region. There's just enough supply to meet demand, but it can't cope with any more outages or any contingencies of any kind.
Power generation has hit a perfect storm, with sanctions forcing Russian supply of coal and gas off the market, flooding in Australian coal mines, and breakdowns in a system under stress as it tries to cope with a shift to intermittent renewable energy like wind and solar.
You can't just shut down a power system that's taken 100 years to develop and change it in a generation.
One of Australia's leading energy experts says there's plenty of blame to share, from federal governments dragging their feet to state governments pushing for rapid decarbonisation.
The real danger is that, you know, promises of renewable power never materialise, while the coal-fired generators and gas-fired generators are constantly under pressure to shut down.
What's needed is sensible, orderly change.
You do really need coal and gas for the time being.
But a lot of damage has already been done, and heavy industry will again be forced to shut down to keep the lights on.
We're really operating nowadays in a third world power system.
Wholesale power prices have surged on the back of the energy crisis, loading more pain on business as costs just keep mounting.
Superannuation increase this year, we will see a minimum wage increase, obviously electricity prices, we're also seeing supply chain costs increase.
The federal government is urging the Fair Work Commission to lift the minimum wage in line with inflation. A ruling is expected this week and it will take effect in July.
We need to be careful not to, you know, promise to too many Australians that the great race has begun.
Then there are interest rate rises.
If you believe markets, they could go from less than 1% today to more than 3% in less than a year.
And on the 1st of August, the alcohol tax will rise in line with inflation. That means bad news at the bar.
Within 6 to 8 weeks, you could be paying $8 or more for a schooner of beer.
Chris Yulman, Nine News.
Good evening. Queensland is tonight at risk of major blackouts, households being urged to conserve electricity.
The energy market regulator forced to step in and order electricity generators to fire up in order to keep our lights on.
It might seem as simple as flicking a switch, but with a complex energy market, keeping the lights on is anything but.
In Queensland right now, there's a lack of supply.
The wholesale price of electricity, what your energy retailer pays, has been soaring in recent weeks. When that price reached a certain threshold yesterday, a $300 per megawatt hour cap kicked in. This meant fewer energy generators put in bids to supply electricity to the grid, leaving a shortfall of 1,400 megawatts, roughly the energy consumption of Greater Brisbane.
What appears to be generators withholding their supply after the price cap has led to the operator being concerned that there's a lack of available supply to meet demand today.
Forcing another emergency measure, the market operator ordering generators to fire up.
They are concerned about shortages in the very short term.
Powerlink, the government body which runs the poles and wires, taking the extraordinary measure today of asking us to save energy by reducing air conditioner and heater usage and turning off computers, TVs and pool pumps between 5 p.m. and 8:30 tonight and again tomorrow until 8 a.m.
I've just heard from the market operator and it seems that the directions it made to generators this afternoon are doing the job. At the moment, there is enough energy in the grid to cover that expected shortfall in Queensland tonight. But we do still need to do our part in cutting back on unnecessary consumption today and into tomorrow. These emergency measures are designed to strike a balance between demand and supply, but an unexpected increase in demand can certainly throw that out of balance, and that is what power companies are trying to avoid so that we don't see blackouts. Now, this is certainly the first real visible sign of the energy crisis in action. And Andrew, we are expecting other states to require similar measures over coming days, so expect to hear plenty more about this.